Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'm just showing you these tips, the Competition Clear from Crystal Nails. These are the tips we're going to use for this set. And I just applied them on my nails, like you see here. And then I just use scissors, or you can use clippers and just cut. I'll show you how I cut them. I'm just using these tips so I can show you how we can cut regular tips to make them almond or stiletto. You can cut whatever you, however way you want. But we're gonna make these an almond shape. So see, here's our tip. I glued it on. Now I'm using some scissors and I'm just gonna cut right here like that. And then on the other side, just like that. And then we'll file them into an almond shape. So see how I'm cutting? I just start like by the middle where the number is on the front of the tip. And then just taper it down like that. So it looks like it's going into a V. So, and if you want a stiletto, you would probably bring it in a lot more. So I'm just getting the file and I'm just gonna start filing them now into a rounded like almond shape. If you want a stiletto, you would just make them skinnier. So you'd cut more off. And so you can do any, you know, you could basically do any shape with the square tips. That's why I'm doing these tips to show you guys. Alright, so see how I'm just blending it all in, filing the sides, making sure we have a perfect shape with our tips, because this is our foundation. We don't want to have a, you know, a whole bunch of tip, and then when we apply our acrylic, we want to file a lot more. So whatever I'm going to use from the tip, I want to make sure I get rid of what I'm not using and keep what I'm using. So remove most of my tip because I really like skinny nails. And I like skinny almonds, so I'm gonna remove a lot of the tip. And I'm blending the tip. See how I'm just filing, I'm removing the shine on the tip. And the only thing is, like if you wanted edge nails or Russian almond and those type of shapes, you need to form them. But see, I'm just showing you the line. It goes straight, just like my free edge, as if the tip's growing from my nail. I filed that part. We want no extra tip. We want to make sure everything's perfect. All right, guys, so we're ready to go. And I've got my protein bond already on, and it's two coats of protein bond on each nail. All right, so see how thin our tips are? When I blended them in, I actually filed a lot of the tip to make them thin. I don't want a very thick application, so our foundation must be perfect. So on to the application of the acrylic. And this glitter I got from Michaels, and I don't think there's a name. It was in a little pack, sample pack, and I loved it. I actually got it for this blue and the green. I think they're like matte. I'm not sure, but I love this blue and the green. So I got the sample packs for these colors inside of it. And I'm just applying my application now. And then I'm gonna cap. So this is the blue glitter. I do two nails. Then I do the other three, the brown, and I think it's called roasted chestnut, but I'll write that in the description box. And the brown is from Glam and Glitz. It's from their Naked collection. And then the blue is the glitter from Michaels. So after the application on the colored, the glitter and the brown, I do cap all the nails with clear acrylic because this is just glitter. We want to make sure we have enough strength. So I'm capping these nails with clear, just like you see I'm doing here. And then the roasted chestnut, the brown nails, I cap that in clear acrylic too, because I don't think the acrylic is strong enough. So I add clear acrylic to make sure we have strength. Alright guys, don't forget to pinch all the nails, and then I'm going to show you the difference between a pinched nail and a non-pinched nail. So see how skinny this nail is? You see the difference? I'll show you when I do the pinky, the difference between the pinched and the not pinched. Alright guys, so we're doing the roasted chestnut, and if the name's wrong, I'm so sorry, I'll put it in the box. But it's the one from Glam and Glitz. And I'm just applying my acrylic bead right here. And then I will cap this nail with clear acrylic, like I said before, for strength. And you guys already know how I do my application, so you can just watch from here. Alright, so see the difference? I'm showing you the ring finger right here and the pinky. So the pinky's still wet. I have not pinched it yet. Look at the difference between the blue nail and the pinky nail, the brown nail. See that tight C curve we have? That's what pinching does for us. See the difference? See how wide this one still is? See, it's not as pinched? See, that's what pinching does. Alright, so I'm just tapping with my orange wood stick to see if it's ready to be pinched. Alright guys, and here's our final results. And I went plain. Like I said, I really liked this blue color and the brown, and I thought they would look nice together. I hope you like it. I'm really enjoying them right now. Don't forget to add your cuticle oil. And I'm really liking them plain right now. So I hope you like these final results and you like the set. Don't go anywhere because I have a review for you. Alright guys, so here's my review. So this is a glass vial, and the company, their name is Zamberg, and they are distributors for germ manicure products. So this glass file is great. I believe it should be the only one you ever need to use. And I was watching their videos to see, and it comes in this really cute case. So I learned a lot from their videos. These tools should be lasting us a lifetime. So I'm showing you, these are the cuticle nippers, and they come with a nice little case too. And watching their videos, which I'm going to leave the link so you guys can go see them too. I've bought so many of these, guys. I've spent $30, $20, and the gap is not as tight anymore. So you'll see here, I'm showing you how the gap is. There is no gap. It's really tight. That's how these cuticle nippers should be. And I learned a lot from this company. So they also sent me a lube oil pin. We should be oiling our tools, guys. I didn't know that. But I'm a nail tech. I didn't know about tools. So I'm just going to show you. They didn't send me these scissors. These are mine. I didn't want to do it on the nippers or anything yet because they're new. But you use your, you see that? And you put a little bit right here of the oil and you lube your tools so they don't rust. And then you just go open them up and close them a little bit, just like that. Open, close. So the oil moves around. So I learned a lot from this company, and I hope you guys will too. I'm going to put their videos in the link below so you can watch them. But they sent me this tool to oil my tools. They sent me this tool to oil all my other tools, and I love it. So they sent me all these, and I think you guys should check them out because of the fact that their products last a lifetime. And if you oil them right and do what you're supposed to do, they will last you a lifetime, opposed to buying. I've went through 5 or 6 of them already, and they're horrible. So they're just the ones that you buy in the stores. And I'm just showing you here again, they're beautiful, guys. And it's Germ Manicure products. The glass file, look at this. They explain on the glass file that there's different ones on their videos. And these ones are made a certain way to last you a very long time. So please check them out, guys. Remember, I love you guys. Thank you so much. And Merry Christmas.